somewhere. So I sent you an invite.
Okay, I'm going to connect now.
So it should, like, when you connect in, you should say, like, in the lower right-hand corner of your notifications, like, on your League of Legends. You should say, hey, Vance wants to add you.
All right, I got an exclamation mark.
Yep.
Bam.
Or a what? I think it's Rogue Orange Juice.
Rogue Orange Juice.
Oh, yep. There we go. So, let me see here. I think we have to play against bots, because you're level one.
At least I start out with a level. That's reassuring.
Is that nice?
All right. Hi, everyone. This is Steve going to learn to play League of Legends from Vance, who's also on the call with us. Say hi, Vance.
What's up, guys?
All right. He's he told me he's a platinum diamond expert in League of Legends, some other various gemstones and precious metals. He says he can teach me the ways.
We hope. We would hope.
So, all right.
So, do you want to just...
Skip
just
waiting for stats. All right. Play? Are you going to send me an invite? How does this work?
Here, I'll do it. So I'm going to do a co-op versus AI, just because I don't think that we can... We'll do a beginner one, because we don't really need intro. Because you have me here.
Yeah.
Except so,
Summoner's Rift, beta.
That's right.
All right, so my emblem is a teddy bear.
Yeah, dude, you can change that. I'll show you how to go through.
Yeah, I don't really care. Match found. Except it's against bots. Okay, what am I looking at, dude?
All right, okay, these are all champions.
Okay.
So
is Polly FL209 another person?
Yeah. So we're all playing against bots.
Okay.
So I'm just gonna say, hey, group.
Are we on a team?
Can me and Steve take bot lane? Yes. And if they say yes, I think they're going to say yes. I don't think they're gonna be dicks. So
there's no AI only.
Yeah, it's the enemy team is AI.
Gotcha.
So pick out. You can pick whatever character you want.
Is there anyone that's terrible and that someone's
no,
gonna bash
all
on
these, all these characters
rules
are really, really
good.
I gotta turn down my.
Like buildings.
I gotta turn down my mixer on my PvP line.
Okay, so I chose Tatted Up Chick, Jinx.
Cool, that works.
Runes and masteries. None of this seems to mean anything.
Not yet. We'll explain that. We'll kind of go over that a little bit later. It's not really. So look at your spells.
Yep.
For right now, you might want to click on them.
Okay.
And change them. Like, I don't know what you have.
I have revive, clarity, heal, ghost, and exhaust. Heal seems valuable.
Yeah, take heal and take exhaust.
I don't have exhaust.
Okay, that's fine.
Revive?
That's okay, yeah. No, you're fine. Well, revive's cool. Okay, so I'm going to kind of talk about what these summoner spells are, like little extra spells. Yeah, we're good. So these summoner spells just give you like a little extra oomph in battle. You know?
Okay.
And you don't really want to burn them if you can't. They're kind of like last-ditch effort, you know what I mean, for whatever.
Okay.
Depending on the type of spell. So you picked heal, and heal will heal everybody around you, and it also gives you a speed boost. So it's good for escapes, it's good for engages, it's good for running somebody down. I wouldn't use it as an engage. I'd use it as like a follow-up, like say, and you'll kind of understand that a little bit later, like team fighting is a little different. And then your revive is, it's kind of nice. You can use it, like, so if you die, revival immediately spits you back out. It's not a spell, believe it or not, none of these really get used very often. Like the number one spells in ranked play are always going to be flash, and depending on what characters you're using, you're either going to use ignite, or you're going to use exhaust, or you're going to use, I mean, heal's pretty big for bottom lane. So it's all really situational, but for right now, I wouldn't worry too much about them. Like, okay. don't try to, you know, we're just worrying on the very basics right now. That's our main.
Yeah, so I guess goal. While we're waiting for LOL only 22 to load, why don't you explain to me the commands? Is this Diablo-style point and click? Or?
Yeah. So your left click is your primary.
Okay.
and you'll see it. It'll click on the ground, and it's very Diablo-esque. In fact, it feels a lot like Warcraft 3.
Okay.
Like, it even has the arrows that point, you know. You'll see it. It's all familiar. They did a really good job with that. And then the four buttons that you're going to use the most are going to be Q, W, E, R, and those are your spells. So your Q spell is usually, well, I'm trying to think of Jinx. Everything changes per champion. That's why the game has such a high learning curve, is because, you know, there's over 100 champions, and it requires a pretty good understanding of every champion in the game.
So how come it only showed me 8 as an option?
Because that's all that's available to you. You know, you gotta buy the rest. So, first I want you to do is I want you to go to hotkeys, like press escape real quick once you load in.
Okay.
Press escape.
Got it.
Okay, go to hotkeys.
Got it.
And put quick cast all. You wanna, yeah. And you should be good. After that, you can close everything out.
Okay.
I just gotta change my resolution. I was using resolution on it. On my smaller monitor. Okay, so now you want to hit, it's P. So hit P and hit the recommended tab.
Okay.
And then just grab your recommended items. And you can just right click on the item and it'll automatically buy it.
Consumables as well?
Okay. Yeah.
I'm out of gold.
Yeah.
I can't buy those.
So you want to buy one Doran's Blade. Just right click the Doran's Blade. 30 seconds until minions spawn. Yep, there you go.
I got everything.
Oh, sorry. I'm watching your stream, and your stream's a little behind.
It's okay. So I'm not moving.
Okay, so you want to right click? Right click your move. I'm sorry, I said left click, didn't I? So you want to right click, and right click will move you around.
All right.
Okay. And then you'll see.
Where'd you go? We bottom, top, or mid?
No, we're bottom. So you see the three lanes?
Yep.
Okay. So that's what everybody's referencing when they say top lane, middle lane, bottom lane. And we're going to be in bottom lane.
Okay, can I zoom out, or am I stuck in this perspective?
You're stuck in there. That's as far as you can go.
Okay.
So that's all part of the game mechanics. That's part of understanding what's going on.
Can I hold down right click?
You can.
Is it actually? Okay, cool.
Yeah, it'll move you around. What do you mean?
These things.
Okay, so you see where it says the pluses above? These are minions.
Yep.
And I'm going to explain that. So you want to take your Q. You want to take your Q ability first.
Okay.
Okay.
It says I have not learned that spell yet.
Yeah, you got to hit the plus.
No.
Okay. And you just want to focus on just getting last hits. And if they come in, punish them. You know, don't. So think of. There you go. Now back off. So make sure you're clicking all the time. Like you're always clicking. Like I'm always clicking and I don't hold it down. So what you're doing right now is you're auto-hitting minions. When you auto-hit minions, it'll push the wave. Sometimes you don't want to do that. Sometimes you do want to do that.
What is that terminology again? It'll push the wave?
Push the wave. Okay, so you see where the blue minions and the red minions meet? You'll see it. Okay, see they're red minions, the enemy minions?
Yeah.
Okay. Think of the blue, where the blue minions and the red minions meet. Think of it as a line of scrimmage. Does that make sense?
Yep.
So the whole idea of this phase is to push our minions into their tower and take their tower.
Okay, so when I'm doing my right click right now, is it using my default attack or is it using my Q?
It's using your default attack.
So my Q rotates between this rocket blast and AR blast.
And you gotta watch out. You don't want to spend too much. Like, so for every rocket you send, for every rocket that you shoot, it uses mana. Gotcha. Dude, what the hell is going on here? It keeps alt-tabbing me out of my game.
But it looks like my primary attack isn't doing anything. It doesn't cost anything.
No. Your primary attack is fine. As long as... If you have the rocket launcher equipped... Whoa, dude. There you go. Beat him up. Okay, so... Dude, for some reason I keep getting alt-tabbed out of my damn game. I have no idea what's going on. Like, it's literally driving me nuts. I'm about ready to kill somebody. So... there's two objectives while you're in the laning phase. And one is, like, if you notice, if you get the last hit on a minion, you get a little bit of gold, right?
Yep.
So it's super important to get the last hit. That's almost your most important goal, is to make sure you get the last hit on minions. You don't want to auto hit unless you're trying to move a lane. So you always see how I just take the last shot. I watch my minions and I take the last shot. Bink.
Yeah.
Take the last shot.
Yeah, I got it.
So that's kind of what you want to do, and it won't freeze the lane, but it's the minimal amount of outside effect that you're gonna have on the lane. Make sure you're clicking on your abilities as you get them.
So just these pluses?
Yeah, and it'll just make sure. Yeah, it'll just level up a certain. And also, when you get an opportunity, when you get the chance, take a shot. There you go. And I'm not saying don't chase them down. You know what I mean? Just like a lot of new players, they get hungry. You know what I mean? They get what I call, they get the old buck fever, and they chase down. They'll chase down enemy members. You know what I mean? Instead of just going, you know, had a good exchange, I'm gonna let that one go. It's not a big deal. You know what I mean? So generally, the idea is you don't really want to chase an enemy team member past the line of scrimmage, because then the minions will start attacking you, and they actually do a lot of damage in groups.
So I seem to just constantly have these gold pluses above my bar.
It's because you're not buying your.
What do I buy them with? Gold?
Nothing. You just click on the plus. Just click on the plus sign.
Okay.
And it'll put a talent point into that.
Okay, gotcha. But what how do I earn those upgrades, I guess?
You just level. There you go. That was actually a really good play.
So the snare, is that a minion or ability, or is that a bot ability?
That's one of... That's one of your abilities? Ooh.
Well, they snare
me.
Yeah,
they're gonna kill you. You better watch out.
I'm running.
Oh.
So what do I do now?
You'll respawn after a while.
Alright.
I should have saved you on that one. I thought they were gonna keep coming after me. So like I'm trying to like I'm like it's funny because I'm like using like whatever. Like I'm like trying to play, but at the same time I'm like, okay, how do I put this in terminology?
Do I need to rebuy those items? Yes.
No.
I don't? Okay.
No, you don't want to buy it. You can buy pots if you want, but you should be able to go down. You're trying to build an item called IE or Infinity Edge. So you want to start buying pieces for that if you can afford it. Wow, I'm horrible last hitting when I don't have any room.
Essential items? Is that what you're talking about?
It should say like in your... It should say...
Like if I'm looking at recommended, I have an essentials item?
Yeah, essential items.
That's what so I'm...
It'll probably tell you to buy your boots first. And that's okay, just buy your boots first, that's fine.
Oh, I'm too far away from the shopkeeper.
Yeah, you gotta be. Yeah, you're like out here now.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Okay.
Ooh, let her have it, dude. There you go. Okay, back off now. What's her name's gonna come in the fray?
So, I have to get within a certain range to hit them.
I'm really low, yeah.
Gotta die sometime.
Oh, I really wish I wouldn't have used my freaking rocket jump. Gosh, dang it.
Our turret?
No, their turret. Alright, someone blew up one of our turrets. It looks like Top is dropping the ball pretty hard.
I was like, we're actually doing decent then?
We're not. I mean, so... It's at this point, it's like really hard. You can stay in lane. It's not a big deal. I'm just going back to buy real quick. Actually, I shouldn't buy until I have 1550. So, you're doing... I mean, if you ever want to see how you're doing, just check your tab. I'm not really, like, at this point, I'm not really worried about you doing last hits and stuff. You know what I mean? I'm not really worried about coaching you on last hitting.
What does tab show me?
Tab just shows you the scoreboard.
What's the scoreboard? 19? Is that my points? Or 1 to 7?
19 is how many minions you've killed. Small minions. So, yeah, think of it as... So think of it as like that. Think of it as like a, oh, you might want to back up. Barrier. Yeah, I didn't think I was going to have the barrier so hard. You probably want to back up. You're going 2-on-1. Just make sure, like, okay, so, like, the huge mistake that I see new players make is that they move, but they don't do any damage. You know what I mean? They don't. And it's what it is. What's going on is you're not, it's a little bit more difficult. They call it orb walking, or attack move is probably the easiest way to explain it. So like when you're running away from people, you kind of want to click to where you want to go, and then click on the enemy real quick. Click to where you want to go, click on the enemy, click, you know what I mean? So you're trying to move and shoot at the same time. And I'll show you how that works in just a second. It's actually pretty difficult.
Every time I click on the enemy, I retreat back towards.
Yeah, so you're either misclicking, or you're there's a couple things that could be going wrong. You're either misclicking or so. So you always want to return damage. You know, you always want to make sure that you're handing out damage. That girl's dead.
Double kill.
So you'll notice, like, okay, so you can click to move. Man, I don't know if I wanna show you. A move is kind of a pain in the butt. Like, it's something you should learn. I don't know if you want to worry about it right now. You know what I mean? It's just, I just don't want to overload you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I'm just trying to think. So we're just trying to understand the one thing I'm seeing you're doing, like, you're auto hitting, and I really don't want you to do that. Like that's a really bad habit.
I'm not sure what you mean by auto hitting.
You're walking up and you're standing in front of the minions and you're just automatically hitting them.
Well, I'm specifically targeting those enemies that I'm.
Okay.
Hitting.
Okay. So then you're hitting them too early. I want you to time it so that you take the last hit. You know what I mean? I don't want you to do any damage unless it's going to be the absolute the killing blow.
So, but what's going to get them down on health?
The other minions are attacking them.
Okay.
See how the other minions are already attacking them?
Yeah.
See how I'm hitting and walking away? Hit, move. Hit, move. Hit and move. Hit and move. Hit and move. That girl's gonna die. So you're constantly, what you're trying to do is you're trying to, like, running away, like, you know, distance doesn't really have. So distance, like, if you notice, like, you kind of run at, like, the same pace all the time.
Yeah.
So, you know, what you're doing is, like, when you hit move, you're timing your attacks, like. So if you look down in your lower left-hand corner, you'll see your character plane, and it'll have like a little sword, and it'll say 0.78, or it'll say, for you it says 0.66. What that's telling you is, like, you can make one attack every 6/10 of a second. So watch, see how the minions are lowering the health? Don't hit it, don't hit it.
I'm not.
And boom, see how I take, just barely take the last bit of health. Someone has disconnected. I'll let her walk away. Dude, she's stuck. What's going on here? Oh, never mind. Man, I'm low on mana. Always watch your mana, always watch your health.
So how much gold do I need to buy an Infinity Blade?
The total cost is like 3,000 something. Start firing, dude. Yeah. Oh, you might have killed her. That's okay though. That's totally normal. So I'm gonna let you work on those minions. Just work on last hitting. And you're gonna be like, you're gonna find out, dude, last hitting is like way harder than we think. You know what I mean? If you really think about it, so like the pros have like a 95% rate of last hitting. So like 95% of the total enemies that you can last hit, the pros are hitting. Which means they're missing maybe one. They're missing maybe one minion every five waves. Maybe every six waves. And that's like, if I was going to set a goal, I would say that, you know, you want to be that way. You want to be able to get, you want to be able to get every minion in every wave. And usually there's six minions every wave, except for, I think it's like every other wave, you'll see a canyon minion spawn.
So how can I come back and heal?
Just press B, and that'll send you all the way back to base.
And that's where I heal?
Yep, unless you buy a health pot. If you have a health pot, you can always click the corresponding number with the item, and it'll heal you.
Or can I hotkey it? Like, can I hit?
Yeah, you can. You can hotkey it. Oh, whatever.
Okay, so now I have to run back to you, though, right?
Yep. Answer Jinx.
Unstoppable.
Yeah.
You think I'm crazy? You should see my sister.
Who's Jinx's sister? Has been
slain. Who's Jinx's sister? Yeah. I don't know.
She said, "You think I'm crazy? You should see my sister."
That's probably just a joke. I haven't really read the lore on Jinx. I've never really thought, like, she's an awesome AD carry, and she gets a lot of play.
She's an awesome what?
AD carry. That's what we're playing right now, is AD carry. So
it's a game mode?
No, AD carry is a position. So you got to think of every character on the map has a position. Watch out. Now watch out. Don't shoot. Whatever you do, like, okay, so we're going to talk a little bit about turret logic. So turret logic is, as long as there's minions under the turret that got there before you did, the turret will always target them first, unless you attack a enemy champion. If you attack an enemy champion underneath the turret will automatically target you. So did you notice that big circle when we came in range of the turret? Did you notice that
the
huge
green circle?
Yeah, that's basically telling you. That's basically telling you that, hey, by the way, the turret. This is the turret's sphere of influence. See it?
Yeah.
That's telling you that's the range of the turret or the turret's sphere of influence. So we're about to take that. Yeah, I'm gonna go mid. Oh, never mind.
You want me to stay here?
Yeah, just stay here and just kill minions. Just keep practicing that last hitting, keep practicing the last hitting.
So you only get gold on last hit.
Exactly. And you can see, like, if you really think about it, so you get 20 gold every time you last hit something, right? So every wave, there you have 6 to 7 opportunities for that. And the canyon minions are even more important, dude, because they're worth 40 gold. I'm coming. Keep running. You're good. Just keep running away. Just keep running. Aww. Oh, you're good. You're good. Aww.
The map is really hard for me to get used to.
Yeah, it's a real... here, let me... You should take all that. There you go. That was a great last hit. That was a great last hit. So just keep focusing. If you can get your last hitting mechanics down and really get accurate with it, you're gonna do really well.
So what's wrong with auto hitting if you have lots of minions and you're just
okay,
like...
There's absolutely nothing wrong with that. That's a great question. The reason you don't wanna do it. The reason you don't want to do it is because you push your wave, but if you have to push the wave, then do it. You know what I mean? That's all I'm saying is it's situational. It's absolutely 100% situational.
Mm-hmm.
So it really depends. That's a decision that you have to make as a player. you know, is do I have to push the wave? If no, if I don't have to push the wave, then you want to do what we call freezing the lane. Freezing the lane is manipulating last hitting mechanics. It's manipulating last hitting mechanics so that you can keep the lane at a certain position, or you can keep all the minions at a certain position in the lane. Oh,
yeah. Bonk. Yeah, I attack
really slow. Oh, you, bro.
I attack really slow.
Well, I've also got a, like, Tristana has a steroid. Like, one of her abilities makes her,
Is that your character?
Yeah. Her steroid makes her hit really, really fast. That's, in fact, in my opinion, it's one of the best late game steroids. I'm gonna go help top real quick. So just make sure and watch yourself. You're at half health. So just keep blast hitting. If you see them, now the thing about bots, dude, you can depend on them to do one thing, and they're always gonna charge you.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So you can always depend on them to charge you, so you can kind of bait that with bots. But don't expect human players to do that. Human players will, like, they'll play correctly, which is one of the reasons why a lot of people feel like you probably shouldn't start on bots. But, like, if you're really new to the mechanics of League of Legends, then it's really good, you know.
So how are you alerted that I'm like the past few times when you ran over here and like saved me? How are you alerted? Like, are you just because you're watching my stream?
No. I'm watching my mini map. I'm watching my mini map like every second, dude. Like, I'm constantly, and that's something that.
Legendary. So I have like 3,400 gold.
Yeah, go back and buy an IE. Infinity Edge.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, IE. Someone in the stream saying that.
Okay, P to purchase.
Oh, I shouldn't have used. Well, that's alright. We're actually gonna do Dragon after this, because if you have an IE and I have an IE.
I need 3,800. I'm at 3,500.
3,500, need 38. Alright, that's okay. Let's. We're gonna go. I'm gonna ping the map. Watch. See where I pinged? That's where I want you to meet me.
Okay.
What we're gonna do is we're just gonna grab a jungle minion real quick. Get you the gold you need. Now what I want you to do is stand right, like, watch where my character is. Stand right here. So you shoot the minion. Okay, just start shooting the big minion. No. Oh, dude, you don't need to move, man. That's why I was telling you, stand right there.
When I clicked it, I automatically moved forward to attack. I wasn't in range.
So let me ask you something. When you click on something, you don't do the old slide, do you? I mean by the slide is you click on something and then you slide while you're still holding the button down.
I have no idea.
Okay, if you have, grab that. Yep. Oh, dang it. I thought you were going to kill it by the time. Just keep going. There you go. Now we can go up into this. We'll just grab you this one real quick. You can just do that. Shoot the big one. Yeah, you're clicking behind him. So switch over to your minigun, dude. There you go. Your minigun is actually a speed increase. See how much faster you shoot with it?
Yeah.
Okay, now you can go buy a. Now you should be able to go buy an IE. Crap, they're gonna get our lower tower, our bottom tower. Not a big deal though.
Tower mean the turret?
Yeah, the turret. Or tower turret.
Okay, so buying this thing.
Yeah. I
said I bought the thing.
Okay, do you have any gold left over?
200.
Okay, come back to lane. I'm gonna go help mid. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just roaming around, just trying to help everybody. I think what I'll do next time is I'll just play a support character.
Legendary. So what does it mean you're legendary? Keeps on saying that.
Oh, it's got 14 kills and 0 deaths.
It's just constantly reminding us that you're gangster.
Yeah, that's just He's just saying, like, hey, by the way, he's killed a few people.
He's killed everyone.
Yeah. And that's, it's, I can't remember if Legendary has 5 kills. Wow, she kept some armor.
So what is the Infinity Edge that I purchased?
If you read it, if you scroll over, it'll give you the stats. And it's just like your main damage item. Now, not everybody builds. I mean, I don't think everybody builds an Infinity Edge on Jinx. I can't remember if some people start Static Shift. I don't know, I don't play her, so I don't know all the build guides. So there's like a million different build guides for everybody.
Well, I'm not sure what that means.
Build guide is, like, so all the items do something. They give you a stat, or they give you on use. Some of them have what we call an on use. So there's different ways to build. You know, there's different items that you can build. There's all kinds of little different things that you can do to play your character a certain way. And some characters respond better to items than others. Like, Tristana responds to crit items really well. There you go. So those are usually, okay, so your Clompers?
Yeah.
Those are usually, you usually use those to keep, I mean, you're using them correctly to keep them from getting away from us or getting to us, but you're more concerned with letting, you know, making sure that they can't get away from us, you know what I mean? Like, right now, I do more than enough damage to kill everybody on their team if I just want to mow through them. So, like, what I would do is you bait them, and if they try to run away, then you use Clompers, watch out. Yep.
Yeah, I thought it was like an AoE attack.
It kind of is and kind of isn't. So what it's used to keep people in place, you know what I mean? There you go. Yeah, she's actually got a really tough kit. Like, well, I mean, anytime you have a skill shot, you know, I mean, Clompers can make or break a lane phase. I'm gonna let you take all that. I'm just gonna go back. So, I mean, you're pushing into the base, so if you want, you can auto-hit now. So there's that decision-making, you know what I mean? There's that, okay, do I want to push in the base right now? Do I want to...
I'm just waiting for minions.
Okay.
Whoa.
Yeah, you're probably going to get jumped on.
Oh, yeah.
Just keep running, dude. In that situation, when you get jumped on by more than one person, just run. Just don't even worry about attack hit, just run, just bone out.
So I retain my items after death, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Otherwise the game would just be, you know what I mean, the game would just be boring. Everybody would be starting over every time you died. And if there is, just in case there was that one person that was able to persist, you know, and not die, he would just snowball out of control.
So LOL only 20. He's also godlike, apparently.
Dude, I don't even know if there's... I haven't even seen Master Yi, and I haven't even seen Annie. That's for real.
So do I go back into lane?
No, we're pushing... Okay, so the goal now is to push into the enemy base.
Okay.
And since we've kind of made a hole at the bottom, it has... Okay, so you see... If you look at your mini-map, you'll see these little round... you see these circles with, like, a diamond in the middle? Okay, that's called an inhibitor, and the inhibitor is like the first stage to getting to winning the game. So once you get an inhibitor, it means that you can move past that to the inner turrets.
Okay. You want to go kill that dragon?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing right now. You want to help?
Yeah, I'm on my way.
Yeah.
Okay.
Should have got a lifesteal item. I have like 0 lifesteal. Yay! So, something that they added, another layer of depth for this season, is the dragon. Every time you kill the dragon, it gives you a buff. And
is there always just one dragon? Or is this purple thing on the map a dragon too?
No, the purple thing, let's go look at Baron. So this is Baron Nashor. So there's 2 main bosses on the map, and they each give a buff and money.
Do you always play on the same map?
Yeah, it's always the same map. So I don't know. We could try killing him. I don't know if we have the. I don't know if I. Well, screw it. Let's try it. Oh, yeah. You might have to run, dude. Run, dude. Run. Run.
I ran.
Yeah. We need a tank. We need a jungle.
A jungle?
Yeah. So, like, a character. So, like. Okay, you notice how we've been running through, like, this little side area the whole time?
Like this river area?
Yeah, like the river, like anywhere that's not exposed, you know, that's not associated with the lanes, we call that jungle.
Okay.
And that's actually a lane in itself.
Like just this middle center one, or all these little squigglies and stuff?
All the little squigglies and stuff. There's all kinds of little, there's all kinds of minions and stuff that,
So is there any benefit to going in here and killing these little gold enemies? Or I assume that's what these are.
Yeah.
There is some benefit to it?
Yeah, absolutely. So I didn't really want to get into it because it's like really... Okay, so you probably won't see junglers until like level 20, level 23. And a jungler is a character specifically built to farm all those minions in the jungle. From level 1 on, and even nowadays it's kind of hard to do. They've actually changed the jungle quite a bit. The jungle's quite a bit harder to make a full clear. So I don't think you really want to focus. Just know that that's what we call it, the jungle. And there's two major creeps. So you'll see like a little fox head on our side. You know, you see the gold fox head? Okay, on your mini-map.
Yeah.
Okay, now you see it?
Yeah.
Okay, those are like big jungle creeps. And that's what we call red and blue. Oh my gosh, dude. Really? This chick's gonna get away? And you'll see, like, the junglers will sit there and farm those creeps. It's just, I can't, like... I'd have to sit down and explain the jungle, like how it works and stuff. It's like almost a game in itself, you know what I mean?
So I just looked at one of the monsters and it said a buff is to restore a large amount of your health. Is that just the person that makes the kill?
Yeah, yeah. So jungle isn't... Jungle, you never jungle with two people unless you're troll as hell. Like, you'll never, like, I just don't worry about the jungle. You're not going to see anybody in the jungle for a while. And if you do, it's on the rare. Oh, there you go. You caught her, man. Nice job. So these are what we call, what we're working on now is called inner turret. It's a lot easier to have like a tank. Oh. Killer? Oh, you could have killed, you could have got a kill. Doesn't matter, I can regen. There's all kinds of, like, someone place a ward or not. Why? We know, dude. I placed a ward. After you got here.
A what?
Oh, okay, a ward is, like, you can place items on the map that'll give you vision. That area, even though you're not in it, and it's called a ward. So victory. That's what that guy was asking. Like, if you read your chat, the guy, Garen was asking, "Hey, place a ward." I guess he wanted to. What's it called? He wanted to teleport to it. So make sure you see where it shows that guy CCS Razor.
Yes.
And it shows his name in red. okay, that means he DC'd or he left or he went AFK. Uh-huh. Either way, we don't care what the reason is. All we know is that you want to click the little exclamation mark.
Okay.
And when it comes up, you scroll down a little bit. It says leaving the game AFK.
Okay.
And then I'll usually just, as an additional note, I just say never showed up. And this is Riot's reporting system.
Mm-hmm.
It's a way for them to kind of keep the riffraff to a minimum. And it's also our opportunity. You know, if we have a teammate that's like just an asshole, or a teammate that decides that, you know, he doesn't want to play, or, you know, just for whatever reason, that's a way you can report that teammate. You know what I mean?
Okay.
And they sometimes discipline. It depends on how often they do it, but most of the time it results in disciplinary action, whether it's a ban or verbal warning or, I mean, shoot, I've seen it all the way. Like, my cousin got nailed. He got banned from competitive play, and he had to win 50 normal games to get back into competitive. So, I mean, it can range from anything. It can be either just a straight up, dude, we don't even want to deal with you anymore, we'll just ban you straight up, to sometimes it's just verbal warnings. Sometimes they'll ban you from competitive play. I'm trying to think of what else. There's all kinds of little ways that Riot has to try and improve a player's attitude.
Mm-hmm.
And it's actually working. They do a pretty good job. I'd have to give Riot kudos for them being able to change the community the way they have. I think it's something like 30 to 40% of players that have been disciplined usually come back, and they're not a repeat offender.
Gotcha. So why is the lane we took called the bot lane?
Because it's the bottom of the screen.
Oh, or, bottom. Gotcha. Yeah. Not like AI robot.
No.
Okay.
No. So, like I said, you know, that's why, you know, you look at the very, like, it's whatever lane.
How many people are on our team?
Five. It's a 5-on-5 game.
So, do you typically go 2 on bottom, like 2 mid, 1 top, or how do you split that up?
So let's say, here, you can pick Jinx again, dude.
All right.
And I'll be your support.
Rules are made to be broken.
We'll actually play a legit lane.
People.
Give me a second here. I need cooldown reduction, ability power. Okay, save masteries. So I'm actually gonna play, and this is like, a lot of people are gonna see this and be like, "What a crappy."
What? Because you're playing the Yeti, ice climbers. What's wrong with the ice climbers?
He's just not in the meta right now.
Oh. So how come I only have 3, 6, 9, 10 champions to choose from?
So every week they rotate, and you just automatically, when you start the game, you automatically get 10 champions, and they rotate. They're the free champions,
mm-hmm.
or we call them rotation champions. So every week it'll be a new set of 10. So you can, and it's so players can come into the game and have a bunch of free champions at their disposal, and two, it's also an opportunity for other people to try out champions before they buy them. You know, to find out if you really like that champion, if it fits your playstyle.
Okay. So how much does a champion cost?
It depends on the champ. Like, we'll go over that after this game. We'll go into what we call the store.
What we call the store? Is that because it's the store?
It's the store, sorry. We'll go into what we call the store.
We call this the store.
The store. This is where you buy things.
Because it's a store.
You buy things. And it's cool. This is going to be fun, dude. I haven't played the Yeti in a long time. He used to be one of my favorite support champions. And then they started introducing all these unbelievably good support champions. And I'm like, oh.
Oh, man, Dragon Chick. She's cool.
Yeah, Shyvana. She's very straightforward.
So what kind of role is Jinx? Is she attacked?
She's what we call an AD carry or a marksman. So
when you're saying 80, are you saying 80 or
after
death, like alpha
after death, alpha delta. So 80 carry is just another way of saying attack damage carry. So you'll notice, like, Jinx, like most attack damage carries, Jinx, Tristana, Ashe, Lucian.
I don't see any of those other people on here.
Yeah, they're not here. Okay. So I'm just saying if you do see them, they're attack damage carries. And they're super weak early game. That's why you send them in a lane with what we call a support.
Mm-hmm.
It's a character that is pretty strong and doesn't have a lot of reliance on items that can sit there and babysit that character while it grows.
Did you ask if we can take bottom lane again?
The way it got set up, we did.
Okay.
I wouldn't worry about it. It looks like everybody's going to take... it looks like Shyvana's going to go top and...
How can you tell all this?
Just the character.
Oh.
And the way they build it. You can usually tell by their first items, like, what they're going to do. Like, if that Master Yi, the ninja guy or the samurai sword guy.
He was on the opposing team, right?
He's on
our team.
He's on our team. Justin, table boss.
There's a ninja on the other team that looks like Scorpion from Mortal Kombat.
His name is Shen.
Yeah.
Shen's pretty rad. Shen's an awesome support, too, but he's just... The problem with Shen is he needs a lot of coordination with your AD carry.
So as a support role, do you give me buffs?
Yeah, I do. I have a buff that I'll end up giving you.
Cool.
My job is to basically be a nuisance and keep them away from the minion creep while you farm.
Minion creep being our blue minions moving forward.
Exactly.
Forward progression.
So
are you actually camo while you're in the grass?
Yeah, they can't see you while you're in the grass. So that's another thing. Like, say you're getting attacked, and you're like, "Oh crap! I don't want to get hit anymore." You can run in there, run in the bush, and you disappear for a second, and they have to come in the bush to see you. So there's methods of actually going in and out of the bush and getting people to follow you in and out of the bush so you don't take any damage. So there's some actually pretty funny vids of like professional players in bronze, just messing with bronze players, and just getting them to do their bidding all day.
Me mid, you top. What is a warding doing? Places a stealth ward the last 60 seconds.
Me, Tarzan. That's your free ward. It goes in your... It's that little item that you put in your fourth. It says number four. Okay. Bonk. Ooh, took a little bit of damage there. Hey, you gotta love the freaking... You gotta love the bots, dude. They'll just go hard all day. Oop. You might want to do a little damage. There you go. There you go. Keep going, dude. Go hard. Go hard. There. Okay, so she got away. That's cool. Back off. Also, if the opportunity presents itself, dude, to do a little bit of damage, take it, man. Donk. Oh, I forgot how much of a mana whore this guy is.
And you regenerate mana just by time?
Yeah. Items will do it too. I should have got the buff. That's okay. I'm gonna take that. Donk.
Oh wow, you can do that much damage one hit?
Just on minions. It's called consume.
Oops.
It's okay. Just make sure you're last hitting.
No, I fat fingered.
That's kind of that's what we call a poke ability. That little ability that you have right there, and you can use that like it's just kind of a long range poke.
Yeah, I thought it would like pass through and hit every enemy in like a line.
Nah, it'd really be so overpowered.
Well, it like showed the trajectory, so that's why I was thinking.
So you also need to get in the habit of if he's gonna stand in front of you, and just like be a goofball like the bot. Just take it as an opportunity to get off a quick auto hit on him. Tarek, the Gem Knight. Yeah, just do some damage. There you go. Make him pay for that one. There you go. Whoops. Okay, he's gonna...
Stun.
I got you. Dunk. Okay, watch out, she's coming to kill you.
Yeah.
I don't know, you need to go.
Yeah.
Okay, so you do a lot of Serpentine. which is kind of cool, but like when you gotta go, just try to run away in a straight line. It's just a...
When you say a lot of serpentine?
Yeah, you tend to like zigzag. You gotta remember, she's not really aiming at you. Like all she has to do is click on you and it's pretty much over.
So I can't avoid, is what you're saying.
Yeah, so just run away in the straightest line you possibly can.
Fair enough. Has been slain. Oh, Scorpion killed Wreck-It Ralph.
Wreck-It Ralph.
That's what it looks like. I don't know.
Still thief. There we go. Yeah. I can get a little bit of mana pots. Didn't realize, dude. I forgot how mana. I forgot what a mana dump this guy is. You definitely need lots of mana. So yeah, you always want to take that opportunity. To get those hat, you know, like if the enemy's gonna give you the option, you know, I mean, always take a last hit, always take a minion kill over a hit, but you know, you always want to be in a position where you can do a little bit of damage and help out. Like we can kill this chick. Oh, got her.
Can't get close enough.
Yeah, so yeah, your positioning was, you were way out of position on that one. So that's okay, that's totally normal, that's what this is about. So you might take a few shots on this guy, man. There you go.
Unstoppable.
Take a few shots, there we go. There you go, good, good, very good, nice trade. Very good. Don't up, you're in the sphere of influence, watch out. Watch out, you're gonna take some damage.
Because I attacked the champion in the thing.
Yeah, exactly. There you go. Oh, dude, there you go. Now back off, he's gonna stun you. Oh, they're going after me hard, man. Yeah, they are going on me hard, man. If they're gonna go on me hard, man, you can go right back to it. You know what I mean? Probably just try to do as much damage as you can. There you go. Watch out, he's gonna try and stun you. Good job. I'm gonna walk up. Here, get ready. I'm gonna go attack him.
Okay.
I'm gonna see if I can bait him out. Grab that first. Get a little bit of health back. Oh, there he is. Let's go. Oh, I don't have a snowball. I don't have a snowball. Yeah, I do. I have it. Don't kill him. Good job.
You think I'm crazy?
Teamwork, man. Teamwork.
So your snowball slowed him down?
Slows them down. So my snowball does a couple things. It slows them down, and it slows their attack speed as well. So it's like, it's kind of a double, you know what I mean? It's something that you want to use every second you can get an opportunity to, you know what I mean? So what I do, what this champion does is I slow down the enemy team's movement speed, and I slow down their attack speed, and I speed you up. And I speed, you get movement speed from me, and you get attack speed from me. So we can sit there and trade with them all day. So like if they want to come in and they want to do damage to us, we'll win that. We'll win the trades every time because you're attacking twice as fast as they are. The trick is that you don't get stunned, whereas if I get stunned, it's not really a big deal just because...
Oh, I'm stunned. I'm dead. I'm so dead. So dead.
Go, keep moving, keep moving.
I tried.
Yeah, you stopped.
Yeah, I, getting used to this map moving is difficult. My mouse didn't move with the map, so I started clicking on myself. That's alright, I have some gold, I can buy some more options.
Whatever, let's just start shooting.
do like the professional players do like the Korean thing where they like spam keys?
Oh yeah, dude. Well, it depends. I mean, you hear their mouse clicks quite a bit. You know what I mean? So, oh, there we go. Yeah, I came in for a gank and didn't tell anybody. Okay. Yeah, you don't. So you don't really need to use rocket unless you're pushing a lane.
I don't want to use it for its AOE to like get multiple last.
Well, that's what I'm saying is if you gotta use it for that, then yeah. Like I said, if you're gonna use it for pushing a lane, it'll push a lane faster than single target. So you gotta make that decision. I'm not saying it's the wrong thing. I'm just saying that.
Pay attention to.
Yeah. Put a bone out.
Unstoppable.
Should have like no mana.
Double kill. Oh.
There you go. There you go. That was a good play. Oh, you could have kept going, dude.
I don't want to run to the minions.
That's okay, as long as you don't go. So see where I am right now, see where my character is?
Yeah.
This is what I call line of scrimmage. As long as you're not barreling through like all red minions, you're okay. But most new players will do this. They'll go way over and they'll start attacking. And they'll be like taking turret damage and getting hit by minions, you know what I mean?
Just making themselves pretty open.
Yeah, I mean you weren't, you know what I mean, there was still, as long as mixture of the two,
yeah.
You're fine. Oh, I should buy some boots too so I can get around the map. So when you're that close to the tower, it's worth it just to do, you know what I mean, push the wave, like switch over to rockets, push the wave really hard, do a ton of damage to the tower. Because I mean, ultimately that's the goal, is
right.
To take their tower down. Watch out, you're going to start taking damage. There you go. We can probably get this tower. Yeah, I'm gonna be tanking it, so it's not a big deal. Oh! I don't know why it switched to you. That was weird.
Alright, hold up. I gotta mute my mic real quick. I'll be right back.
No problem. You keep farming, bro. I'm gonna go mid.
Legendary. You have the best intentions.
An ally has been slain.
Legendary. Double kill. Your team has destroyed a turret.
Ah, come on. What's the worst that
your
can happen?
Your team has destroyed a turret. Legendary. Double kill.
Alright, sorry about that.
Yeah, no worries, man.
So that got really easy at the end.
We had two. I don't know what they're doing, but it looked like two guys that either that's all they do is play bot games or whatever, you know?
Yeah. Like.
So yeah, they just basically ran. It's what we call carrying.
Uh-huh.
So they just got a ton of kills and carried. Like, they probably could have won the game without anybody else. Which is... Let's see here. We do intermediate, except the bots get really... Whatever, we'll do intermediate. The bots are just going to get really aggressive, so...
Alright, we'll try it. We'll do this one game, and then I'm calling it.
Okay. Yeah, it's already 10:40.
Yeah, I got work tomorrow, unfortunately.
Yeah. I think I'm going to call it 6, so I can just get some projects done, and...
Match found, except...
Yep.
Alright, same character, you think?
Yeah, you can do that. You can play. It's always good to play.
Rules are made to be broken.
Similar character. Let me see. I wonder if Thresh.
What people?
Cause I've got like two supports, man, that I play the living crap out of. Eh, what the hell? Play some God Crank.
Mid top JG. What does that mean? JG. Jungle?
Could mean. Hold on, let me look at. I only have 8 points. That's weird. Yeah, jungle. I don't know how that guy's. Oh, he does have smite. Oh, that's cool. Keep forgetting. I guess it is only. Let me take exhaust. I guess you only really need level 10. So, yeah, he's playing Warwick. Warwick is like. He's one of the tier one jungles right now. And if you are gonna jungle, like, if you are gonna jungle, that's the character that I would tell people to jungle with.
Looks pretty rad.
Yeah, Warwick is what he does. He's a lifesteal champion. So, like, you can build him one of two ways. You can build him really tanky, or you can build him attack speed lifesteal. And basically what he does is he just gets on somebody and he what we call a heal tank. So yeah. The whole time they're hitting him, it doesn't matter. He's healing through it constantly.
So we're red team now.
Yeah. Well, purple. We're purple.
Does that mean we started the opposite side of the map?
Yeah, you'll see it. It's kind of weird. It changes things up, but it doesn't make a huge difference. Especially at this level, it's not that big of a deal.
So above my health, I have a little green bar. A little green dot, 74, 75, 73, 26.
What is where?
This? Right above the percentage above my name.
Oh, that's your ping. It's your connection, it's your ping, it's your latency.
Oh, okay. I can't see everybody else's though, just mine.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Now, what the hell was kicking me out the whole time?
Now you're alt-tabbing Ghost?
Yeah, it was really weird, so I'm like trying to figure out what it was.
So what are we waiting on? Why isn't the game... Oh, we're on Shokanju.
Oh, there we go. He's dude, don't even ask, man.
He's 100% now.
I can't stand it when people use, like, anime names or they put numbers in their name, dude. It's just, like, Number Man's not bad, but, like, when it's, like, XX Viper Squad, man, Triple X, or... The best is, like, you always run into somebody that's, like, Sephiroth 27.
Okay, are we going bottom again?
Yeah.
Which is actually top, or it's still truly bottom?
No, it's bottom. It's always going to be bottom of your minimap, so. See, if I take Relic Shield, I can heal you. Which will be good. This guy might need help. Should ask him.
What guy? Jungle
he
guy?
Jungle guy might be starting blue.
What does that mean?
I'll show you in a second. It's like, you see my character where it's running to?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is what we call, blue golems. Or the blue buff camp. So, like, every jungle minion now gives a buff. But there's two big ones. Like, every once in a while you see a character and they'll have, like, a red ring underneath them or a blue ring underneath them or sometimes both. Is what it is. Like, the dragon? No, the dragon's just... That's more like a fire ring.
Oh.
Like, you'll see what I mean. It's almost like blue runes, you know? It'll make sense. I don't know where this idiot's starting, and I don't know... Is he starting red or blue?
Let's just behave. Said no one ever.
Minions have spawned.
Okay, starting blue, he's coming my way. So I need you over here, actually. So what we're going to do is called a leash. We're going to leash it for him.
Okay.
And just let him attack it first, then start doing damage to the big one. And it always spawns, so you want to watch your timer at 155 is when it's going to spawn. And I'll tell you when to pull off. Okay, there it is. Start shooting. And pull off. He should be able to smite it. Don't worry about him, man.
So come we on. Just let him finish off.
Yeah,
the
yeah,
thing?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, if he has half a brain, he'll be able to smite it.
Whatever.
Like, that's the normal. I got gotcha. You. Yeah. Oh, whatever. Yes. Watch out, now you're just taking damage. Okay, up. Oh, yeah, you probably want
to.
There you go. 6, 5. Yeah, this is gonna be rough, dude. So you're gonna have to learn how to return damage, man. But these guys are just gonna eat you. Like, if you let them just come in your face, like, Watch out. Oh. Yeah, I didn't have a... I didn't have a what's it called? Didn't have a grab.
Ask me if I'm listening.
Oh, whatever. Come on. Oof. Computer's getting scary, dude. Just stay back there and just shoot away. Oh. Watch out. Yep. Good. Very good. Very, very good. Oh. Yep. You're misclicking. That's why you went walking up there that far.
Yeah.
Got her. Oh, come on. Never mind, never mind. Back off, back off. Dang it, that was my fault, dude. I should have knocked him. Oh, I didn't have the mana for it. I just now got the mana for it. I haven't played this guy in a while. Oh, I'm gonna get blown up. You wanna shoot that plant, dude.
Plant?
Yeah, like that big. You didn't see her form, that big plant right behind you. Watch out. Like right there. Watch out. Oof, back off, back off, back off, back off. Man, where's my grab when I need it?
What's your grab do?
It just grabs and pulls it to me. Like, remember how I pulled her? Like, I pulled her under the turret, dude?
Yeah.
And if you would've got some damage off, we would've killed her. So, it's just one of those deals where it's like, I probably should've told you about that. It's like a really, like, right now I'm relying on you for all my damage, but I'm also able to create situations where they can't hurt you. Just back off, just back off. Don't take any damage from the creep. Just let them attack the tower. Don't run away. Where are you going?
You told me to back off.
I just don't. You don't need to go that far, bro.
How far? How do I know how far they're going to chase me?
The turret. They only go to the turret.
Oh, all right. So they might run past the turret.
No, no, they're not going to. They'll always go to the turret. There you go, nice. There you go, nice. That was two solid last hits. Okay, watch out. We can't win this because I'm really low. We want to... Oh, come on. That was a bonk. I should have hit that one. That was bonk. Watch out, watch out.
What's the worst that could happen?
An ally has been slain.
Oh. 2-1, come on.
Dance for Jinx.
Dude, freaking cooldown timer on this thing is... Hi, how you doing? I got her. Killed ya. And dodged it. Sometimes. This guy playing Katarina doesn't really understand how the character works.
Yeah, me either.
Oh, please come out. Come on out. Throw a spear. I'm gonna catch her. I'm gonna catch her. There we go. Keep going, man. Keep going. Hard, hard, hard. Hard, hard, hard. Oh. Hard, hard, hard. Oh, never mind. We're too far past. Just keep farming, dude. Okay, get ready. This chick's gonna start throwing plants at you, so get ready to start dodging. Alright, there we go. Now I got a little bit of health.
Yeah, how much does a potion regen?
200 health, I think. 150 over 15 seconds. So you got to think of it. It's one of those, like a potion, you don't hit it and it automatically restores all your health.
Yeah, it takes time.
Yeah. So, yeah, it's definitely one of the things, like, I have a hard, like, I've had a hard time explaining that to a lot of players, dude. Like, they just don't. It's, you know, everybody's so used to potions working a certain way.
Yeah.
Whoop. Dead. Got her. You will not die in vain. Although it doesn't do me, it honestly does like our team like literally no good for you to die and for me to live. Like honestly, it does nobody any good. Oh, whatever.
So is there like a support class that buffs the minions, the bots?
Not really. I mean, you can take it. There's an actual spell that you can take that'll buff the minions. It's like, I can't remember. Oh, are you kidding me? It's almost like the computer knows I'm going to throw it. It's like it dodges like right at the last second. I'm like, oh. There you go. Get behind me. There you go. Oh, so close.
Tried my long range thing.
Yeah. Believe it or not, when you're DPSing, like you really don't wanna switch. Like if you're doing damage to somebody, you don't ever wanna switch guns, like in the middle of it. Oh, that's not good. Hey. I really wish I had some. Oh, I got health, but I have no mana. Which sucks. Keep going, man. In fact, I can go back for a second while you farm. Just keep running, dude. Just keep running. Oh, he ignited you. Did you take barrier or did you take heal or any of that? Any of those spells? Summer spells?
Yeah.
Okay, you probably could have healed yourself out of that.
You told me no one ever uses those.
Heal?
Yeah.
Well, you use it in that situation.
Okay.
That's like I said, that's why the game has such a steep learning curve, bro. Is because everything is situational. Like... Like, what summoner spells did you take? Let's take a look.
Heal and Ghost.
Yeah, so you could... So Ghost will make you run fast. If you ever get in that situation again, you can pop Ghost and run out. Or you can pop Heal.
Yeah.
So that's what I meant, you know, your summoner spells are a last-ditch effort. And that would have been, like, a perfect last-ditch effort. Just keep going, man. You're just getting tons of farm. Oh! I thought you were gonna kill that thing, man. I was like... Oh. Are you kidding me? What did you buy first? You didn't buy boots first, did you?
No.
Yeah. No? Oh, you forgot to... Have you bought anything yet?
Just the recommended item first.
Okay. So when you go back, if you have, like... Oh, man. It's
I can buy boots.
No, because the boots aren't really gonna... Oh, what? How did I not hit that guy?
I don't have enough money for anything else.
Okay.
Some potions.
That's fine. Pots and boots. That's always good, too.
I have my boots. Has been slain.
Oh, you didn't?
No. You said it wasn't useful. I buy it.
Well, not right now. You want to build a little bit of damage, but what'd you buy? Just pots? Alright, don't, if you can buy boots and pots.
I can. Sure.
Well, no, come on, let's get back to lane. Oh, come on, really? That was such bunk. Okay, back off my car. Oh, man. Oh, I see what's going on. You are way low level. That's why you're not doing any damage. See how you're level 6 and they're level 8?
Yeah.
That's kind of a big gap. It's a big disparity. Oh, gotcha. You're dead. Oh, keep running.
Is that, like...
That's an ulti. That's like her passive. Every time you kill that character, she's gonna do that. It sucks, man. It sucks. It's like the worst passive ever. Because she can kill you from beyond the grave.
So, should I like go and kill stuff in the jungle?
No. Just go back and heal real quick and then get back to lane as fast as you can.
Okay.
The jungle creep at this point will just tear you apart. They'll just rip you a new one. Looks like not even worth it. Oh, come on! It couldn't even give me that? Like, really?
Let's just pray. Send a whatever.
I can't believe I got that one. Rocket grab! I'm building such a weird build. I'm sure those people, if anybody's watching the stream, they're scratching their head going, what? Does it make any sense?
As long as it works, right?
yeah. As long as it works. I don't know if it's gonna work.
Why is that dude just chilling in the jungle?
He's killing. Oh, you got her, dude. You got her. Nice play. Let me see if I can get you some health back real quick. So, like, as I kill these enemies. There you go. Okay, so now I got you a bunch of health back. Oh, what? There we go. Come on, dude. Me and you. I'm gonna go hard. Oh, never mind. She got away. That's alright. That was a hard one to read because I just went balls deep on that one. Dude, I can still grab you, kitty. Oh. Wow. Oh. I can't believe, dude. The stupid computer's been doing that all day, dude. Where it just like baits it and then it just sidesteps it real quick. And I'm not gonna lie, dude. It's so rare that a player would do that. Oh, gotcha. Go hard, dude. Kill her. Oh, you misclicked, bro. You misclicked. Get out of there. Oh, misclicked and then ran through the minions. Cardinal sin.
Well, I think I'm level 10 now.
Yeah, that's a good thing. You should be recalling here pretty soon. Yeah, you got 5 seconds in the DT, death timer. How much money do you have?
2,800.
Alright, man. Start buying some items from the Infinity Edge. You should be able to afford a BF sword and a pickaxe.
I don't know what a BF sword is.
BF. So when you click on Infinity Edge, it'll break it down into a bunch of different pieces that you have to put together before you can build it.
I don't know what you're talking about. I can buy a Shiv, or I can buy a Late Whisper, or I can buy a Phantom Dancer.
There's no Infinity Edge?
No.
Oh, really?
There it is, yeah.
Yeah.
But it's grayed out, I can't buy it.
Yeah, no. So click on it.
I need to buy those three.
Yeah. So yeah, most of the big items are whatever, dude. I'm so tired of that crap. So tired of this.
I'm trying to
execute.
Such BS, man.
What's that?
It's just the computer. It's just like it sidesteps everything. Like I'm like, oh, that's a good pull, and like. Playing against other humans, it would have been a great pull. You're like, oh, that's a pull. Alright, you ready, dude? I'm gonna grab this chick.
Everybody?
If she'll ever come back. Oh, here we go. Whoop! See? Dude, the minute I throw it, it knows immediately. It knows immediately sidestep. It's like pro level status, dude. Like even in platinum, people won't read it. The computer reads it perfect. I've never had so much trouble hitting a pole.
I'm thinking.
Oh, come on. Never mind. Just push the wave. Push the wave as hard as you can. What are the other laners doing? Watching you lose your lane, bro. So you gotta hurry up and get back here.
Get back where?
To mid, where they were pinging on the minimap.
Easy.
Yeah, didn't see any other pings.
Oh shit. Oh, dude, that would have been a perfect ulti. Like, what's her name's ulti? That would have been a perfect ulti. Oh my god, really? You gotta be kidding me. Yeah, it's a good thing that Katarina just went running into the middle of him and then didn't do anything. Holy hell. Yeah, watch out for that. See, Katarina should have her ult before she goes. Yeah, that Katarina is. Yeah, wow. Like, just read a few tooltips about the character, man.
How do you do that?
You just look at the. You just scroll over the abilities and they tell you what they do. I can't believe I didn't kill him.
Ah, come on. What's the worst that could happen?
Oink. Not going anywhere.
Enemy rampage.
I accidentally did that on purpose.
Yeah, oh, well. Just clear the wave. Get it to go. Like right now, we're gonna have to turn you into a turret clearing. All you do is you push waves into turrets now. That's your job. Now we need this turret, by the way. So just don't hit him, just hit the turret. What? Oh, shockwave wants to hit him. No, you don't ever want to do that.
do it.
Now you're taking damage. So like when you're on the, when you're doing damage to the turret. Down honkies. Yeah, you don't ever want to. So like if you do any kind of damage to them while you're hitting the turret's going to turn on you, and that's what happened. You put your chompers down and the turret just immediately turned on you, man. You don't want to do that. Like it was a good idea, but you don't want to do any damage to the enemy team while you're sieging a turret, while you're going up against their turret. Just because you just don't want the turret to turn on you, you know, while you're trying to do damage to it. Oh shoot. What? Somehow the computer just happens to get a bush down. Just happens to get a plant down. Yeah. Oh, watch out, back off. Yeah, dude. Yeah, you don't wanna go running into that if you can avoid it.
So now we're like desperately trying to kill the AI, right?
Yeah. Well, the problem is we have, so we could do it really easy. The problem is our team is just kind of like whoever's playing Cat is kind of retarded. Like she keeps trying to do the same thing over and over and over, and it's just not working. So like any normal person would be like, this isn't working, so I probably shouldn't do this. Oh crap, yep, of course. We can get a few hits off. Keep running. Yeah.
Sorry, like, what am I supposed to do?
Yeah, like, in that case, you just don't shoot, you just keep running. You know what I mean? It's just like, it's hard. The problem is, see how our team just keeps running in one at a time? This is really stupid. Like, and that Warwick, like, literally did nothing to help us. Oh, come on. Yeah, see, that Warwick is just worthless. Dude, turn on. Get the freaking, are you kidding me? You gonna run right by the kitty? Come on, man. Really? You gonna run?
An enemy has been slain.
You're starting to bore.
Come on, man. You're gonna hear me yelling at our teammates quite a bit because they're just like. That was just retarded. Like, there's absolutely no reason to run by an enemy. Like, the two of us are running and the kitty cat jumps in the way. It was like an easy kill, an easy pickup. Instead, the girl's like, oh, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna keep running until I get Garen. I need to clear this wave, dude. Oh, there it is again. Of course! Oh. All our teammates, man. Oh, one's got a 35 second death timer. Oh my gosh, dude. Warwick, you are so bad. He just got blown up. It's like the enemy team is just way too built. And our team is just. Like, this guy played Katarina against a Swain. Nah, it's always good to. The point, like, if you're winning all the time, you never learn it. You know what I mean? So, I mean, it doesn't really do any good to just sit there and stomp with robots all day. Unfortunately, I mean, you just had the unfortunate luck of getting stuck in a game with a bunch of guys who, they're probably really new players. Although, you know, I mean, I'd like to think that, like.
Enemy
there's, you know, if you do one thing and it doesn't work, and then you do it again, it doesn't work again, you do it again, it doesn't work again. It's like about 6 or 7 times into it, you know, if you're not scratching your head going, this isn't working, how can I make it work? Then, you know, stop doing it. You know what I mean? Whereas we just have the unfortunate luck of where we're playing with a bunch of people who don't have that cognitive thing. You know what I mean? It's just like,
yeah, I guess.
Well, at this point, there's no basic strategy. The only thing we can do now is get you friggin' built. Dude, turn on. Oh, never mind. Just back it. Start killing these. Is what it is we're going in one at a time. Back off, back off, back off. Back off, back off, back off, back off.
Destroyed.
See this idiot? This the Warwick?
No.
You don't see him on your screen? Got all the flames on him.
Oh yeah. I do?
Yeah. So watch him, he's the moron. Okay, notice he did literally nothing, he just died. So instead of like fighting under the towers and forcing the robots to come under the tower and try and kill him. He came out to them to farm. Came out there. Watch out. Don't pull away from the tower, dude, or they'll just come and get you. And watch the once the Warwick spawns, he'll do it again. He'll run out. Oh, come on. Bubble piss vinegar. Clearing the waves as fast as you can. Keep clearing the waves as fast as you can. And try not to take, you know, let him hit the tower, don't take any damage. Got her. Oh, come on. Yeah, no, stay behind me at all times, dude. They're just gonna blow you up every time. Stay back. 2, 1. Just stay behind the tower of you and just clear the wave. And I'll get one. Watch, I'll pull one. Just let the towers do all the work. There we go. Got one. See how that works?
Yep.
So just stay behind me and we'll figure this out. We'll get one. See that idiot? This ribbon's pulling way too far out. She's getting greedy. Stupid. Player. So they're basically, those two guys are backdooring right now. Stay back, stay back, stay back. I can't afford to have you go down, dude. Like, you have to stay in this game. Oh. Yeah, the minute you pull out from behind those towers, dude, they're gonna go after you hard. Dude, they're just back there. They're just back there taking everything out. Oh, hello. You're dead. Where's my idiot? Where did Riven go? Did Riven just run to her death as usual?
Jinx? Stands for Jinx.
The problem is I don't want to pull Garen, man. Oh, the big ones. The big minions, you'll see them. Dude, I'm so low on health, you guys. You're gonna have to guard, dude. Just all you do is just get rid of all the minions, man. Here, I'll help you. There we go. I'm dead. Oh, Katarina, you built wrong. Oh wow, she built way wrong.
Shut down.
Use your Deathfire Grass, man. You bought it. Yeah, this Katarina's not using her DG. She probably doesn't even know she has it. She probably just bought it and then. That's alright though. That happens. It takes a while to figure out. On-use items are kind of hard to. Wow, we're actually fighting back. Those guys. So while we were protecting our two inner turrets, those other guys were knocking down. Knocking down the oh, what do you call them?
Inhibitors.
Yeah, inhibitors. There, thank you. They're knocking the inhibitors down. So it gave us some breathing room. We should try and do dragon. Dragon buff. Dragon buff. Dragon buff. Dragon buff.
Your team has destroyed a
I don't know why she's tanking it, but there we go.
So now what?
How much money do you have?
34.
Oh, dude, you should go buy a static shiv.
What?
Oh, we're both dead. I might be able to get out of here. Just because I got that nice little.
Yeah, where should I go? Middle lane?
Yeah. Oh, hello.
An enemy has been slain.
That'll work. Yeah, once you have your static shift, what do you got? So you should have money left over from your static shiv.
Yeah.
How much did you have left over?
A grand.
Oh, should have bought boots too, bro. Oh, this is gonna suck.
What's that?
Oh, Riven's gonna die, trying to take this power. Oh my gosh, you're level 13. Oh my gosh, dude, we gotta get you farmed so hard.
You mean what?
We gotta farm you so. You gotta farm super hard.
What does that mean?
It means you need to farm minions.
Okay.
It means you need to kill. You need to start killing the crap out of minions. Wherever you can get minions, just kill minions.
Okay.
Because you're way under level, dude.
14.
Yeah, but look at everybody else on the map. Like if you tab, like everybody is 16, 17. Oh, yeah, especially Garenbot. Oh my gosh.
An enemy has been slain.
Dude, he's so big right now. That Hansel, he's so hot right now.
All right, so you want me to buy boots now?
Yeah. Well, you should. How much money do you have?
16.
You have 16. So buy boots and then try to buy an item from. Last Whisper. Try to buy a piece of a Last Whisper.
Okay.
Oh.
Alright. 1 second, I'll be right back.
Ugh, missed it. Dude, our freaking. Our Riven, man. Our Riven's like a huge source of our damage, dude.
Shut down.
There we go. That'll work. I killed him with static. Static electricity. Whoops. Sorry, bro.
An enemy.
Nope, you're not going
slain.
Anywhere. Oh.
Your team has destroyed a turret.
Your team has destroyed.
Oh, that was actually a good play. That was actually a really good play by that robot. I didn't think he had a lantern. Hey, we won. So, are you kind of getting the idea of moving around and stuff?
Yeah.
That's all you need to really focus on, dude. Like, I didn't... The reality behind it is, like, when you first start playing the game... Oh, here. I'm also going to show you how you buy champions and stuff. So, once you get out to the main window... You'll see in the upper right-hand corner, it'll say your name, and it'll have, like...
Riot points?
Yeah, riot points is one way. Riot points you have to buy. And then on the right-hand side of the riot points, it'll say influence points.
Yep.
It'll be like two cross swords. Okay, so click on the little orange button. And it'll take you to the store. And you just go to champions on the left-hand side.
Okay.
And then you want to go by sort by. And you want to sort by price IP, because that's influence points.
Okay, so there's a few things I can buy, but
yeah,
this shit's expensive.
Some of it is. So like the way I have it set up is I always have lowest price, lowest to highest.
Mm-hmm.
So the first, you know, your first tier of champions are usually 450 gold, and then your second tier is 1350. Influence points, I should say.
And does that mean they're better because they're more expensive?
No, it just means they're newer. I don't think anything's better. Like once you really get into the strategy of the game, like champion matchups and stuff and team composition,
mm-hmm.
you start to realize like save for a very few champions, every champion has a place in the game. Like every champion can like there's a point in the game where they shine. And unfortunately, like there are those few champions that, just in all reality, they just for whatever reason they just nobody plays them. They don't really shine in any particular area. I mean, you can still play them, but you know they're not champions that are.
Commonly used or whatever.
Well, they just weren't designed very well.
So how do I earn influence points?
Just by playing. Just by winning games, and even if you lose games, you get a couple influence points.
So I didn't. I mean, I started with 450, and I still have 450.
Really?
Yeah. So I didn't gain or lose any over the past few games.
Hmm. I wonder if robot games just don't. I wonder if bot games just don't give you influence points anymore. That could be it.
Oh no! Maybe I'm looking at riot points. Maybe I did start with 0 influence points and now have 450.
Okay, so you have... Do you have riot points, too?
I have riot points, yeah. 400.
Oh, wow. You must have been gifted.
So, I think...
I gifted some riot points.
I think I started with those, and then I've earned the influence points.
So you got 400 riot points.
Let's see. If I go look at my match history, our first game, I got 265.
Yeah.
Our second game, I got 54, and that last one, I got 131.
Yeah.
Sorry, other way around.
Yeah.
So 131, 54, then 265.
Yeah.
Cool.
So the 54, yeah, when you lose, you get like half or less than half.
We won all of our games.
Did we?
Yeah.
I wonder why I only got 54 points. Maybe it's because we just didn't. Maybe it's because...
It's where we got carried.
Okay, so the length of the game has a lot to do with it, too. It's like if the game doesn't go very long, it's...
Gotcha.
You actually get less points.
All right, man. Well, hey, I'm calling it. That was fun.
Yeah,
I'll try it again. It wasn't too bad. It's still complicated. I definitely need some practice, but
yeah. See, that's the problem. Is like, just don't worry about like